Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I'm going to teach you about one of my favorite products that I carry in my Pelican case at every show that I go to, and that is the Sonnect Sound Bullet. Now, I'm going to tell you all about how to use this thing and why this is my favorite. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I am all about helping you feel more confident in your production gear no matter where you're starting from. So let's go ahead and dive in. Now, this thing is awesome. I have it in my Pelican. I've had it in my Pelican for the last couple years. I purchased it myself, and this is my first time actually making a video for you guys to actually learn about this thing. But I love this thing, and at every single show I'm at, I have this in my Pelican, and I use this for generating tone or testing snakes or cables and everything like that. Now, there are a bunch of features on this thing, and I want to show you all of the features today. Now, there is a sine wave and a pink noise generator in this unit, and so we can just go ahead and turn it on, and then we can select between a pink noise and a sine wave just by pressing select. So now we can see this little light is kind of dimming and going through, which is the sine wave. Now, this has an XLR in, an XLR out, and it has a quarter inch adapter for it. So we can not only use it as an input or an output on the quarter inch, and I'll teach you about that here in a little bit. The other thing that it has is a phantom power tester. So if you plug this into a snake that has phantom power enabled, you can see if phantom power is actually making it down your XLR to your microphone, for instance. So maybe you have a condenser microphone underneath your snare drum and it's not working. So you can grab this, go plug it into that cable right where your microphone is, and you can see if phantom power is active or not. And if it's not, then you know where your problem is. And if it is, maybe you need to grab a different microphone. The other thing that this has is a built-in speaker. Now, I can go plug this into an audio source and listen through this little speaker with this volume knob here, or I can plug in a set of headphones, like my in-ears, into this and use this volume knob for the volume into my in-ears. And now I can go test a full set of outputs, maybe for record testing or testing a monitor send, that sort of thing. And I can listen to it through my headphones. Now, the other great thing is once you plug in a set of headphones into this jack, it will interrupt the audio for the speaker, which is fantastic. The other thing that this has is a rechargeable battery inside, and it is USB-C powered, and the battery lasts a pretty good amount of time. So I've only had to charge it a number of times, and pretty much any time I use it, I'll just go toss it on the charger once I'm done using it, and it always has a charge for me. The other thing that it has is a cable tester built into this, so I can grab an XLR, plug it in on both sides, and test a cable that might be suspicious and see if any of the cables pins are bridged or missing and that sort of thing. So let me actually show you how to use this. I have my Behringer SD8 and my Behringer X32 here, and I have these four channels. And so let's go ahead and actually get this thing tested. So we have the sound bullet here, and the user interface is actually pretty easy. We have our power switch right here, and we can see that we have our USB-C power port here. So you can recharge this just using a USB-C and a simple power supply for that. Then we have a couple of different things here. We have our level switch. So this offers both a sine wave, if it is flashing like that, or pink noise, if it's like that. And we can just switch between the two signals by pressing this button. We can also change the level of our pink noise being outputted by this switch down here. So this offers a negative 10, a negative 40 in the middle, as well as a negative 20. So when I'm checking a stage snake, I'm typically just leaving this at negative 20. And then right here, this shows 48 volts or phantom power. So we can actually test if the box is outputting phantom power or not, which is great. So you can just ask your front of house engineer to activate phantom power on all of your inputs, and that way you can check to make sure that all of the wires are working correctly, because if phantom power only shows up on one leg, then that means that there is an issue with your wiring. So when we have this set to negative 20 and on pink noise, I'm just going to go ahead and plug this into my first input, which is my kick drum, which does not require phantom power. So we can hear that pink noise, and we can see that it's nice and loud over here on my screen. And if I activate phantom power, then we can see that we now have phantom power here on the unit. And so I'll go ahead and turn off phantom power, and it will take a second for it to turn off. There we go. Now, we can also switch between our pink noise and our tone. So 1K tone is what we have as well. And then we also have our level adjustment. So you won't be able to hear this because of the amount of compressors that I have, but as we watch our input here, this is negative 20, here is negative 40, and here is negative 10. So we can test both mic level and line level on this same unit. Now, if I move this down to my next channel, we can see that this one has phantom power, and this is my kick in. And so then we can go move to my snare top, and my snare bottom, which will have phantom power. And you can just move down the snake completely, input by input, until you have all of your channels tested. Now, the other great thing about the Sound Bullet is not only can it generate noise, but it can also listen. So there is a built-in speaker here on the side of the unit with a volume knob here. So I have pink noise being generated on my console on my outputs. So now I can go ahead and test every single output to make sure that it's generating noise. So as I plug this in, we can hear that in my microphone. And so I have the ability to vary the volume with this little knob right here. Now, another aspect about this unit is I can plug in a set of headphones right here, and then that will automatically turn off the speaker on the outside and go straight to my headphones here. And the volume knob will also adjust that as well. Now, what's great about this is not only can you test all of your outputs, but you can also listen to the outputs and see if the audio is clean or not. Now, what's great about the Sound Bullet is we also have a quarter inch output and input on this unit. So there's a little quarter inch adapter, and we can go ahead and plug this in. And now we can listen through the headphones or the little speaker to, say, a guitar pedal to find a ground loop or a buzz or a hiss. But then also we can press this button and route our audio to the tip of this adapter. So now we have the ability of sending pink noise down a guitar set of pedals or even a direct box to test direct boxes in their setup. Now, one other great function of the Sound Bullet is that there is a built-in cable tester here. And so if we press and hold select for 2 seconds, it will then go into a cable test function, which now we can plug in an XLR into the input and the output, and it will cycle through showing us connectivity of the different pins. So if we had some pins flipped or bridged, it would show on the output and the input of where that is going. Or if we had a cable that had a full air gap, then it wouldn't even show. Like that. Now, one other thing is if we were testing a cable, we didn't actually have to go into the cable tester because if we plug this in, we can hear that we have sine being generated on the output all the way to the input. And that is as simple as this thing is. So this is the full kit. So we can see that there's a really nice carrying pouch and it has a magnet for once it closes and a little carabiner to clip it to your belt or whatnot. So again, this is one of my favorite things that I have in my Pelican. I purchased it. I've been loving it for the last while. So my Sound Bullet replaced my Whirlwind QBox. Now, the Whirlwind QBox is a great box. It's big, though. It takes up a lot of space in my Pelican, and I carry a 1510, and it's a smaller Pelican case. So I have not much space to spare with all the stuff that I bring. But the nice thing about this is it's small. But the QBox, the only thing that the QBox can do that the Sound Bullet can't is that the QBox can test a powered comm line. So say you are testing a ClearComm party line that's powered on a single channel. You can actually take that party line, plug it into a Whirlwind QBox, and test that comm and actually listen to it on the QBox. The Sound Bullet does not have the blocking capacitors for that use with the Sound Bullet on testing comm. So that's the only thing that you can't do that the QBox can. But because of the size of this, that's why this has replaced my QBox. The other thing that it has is the quarter inch input and the quarter inch output. And so there's a lot of benefits of this over the QBox, but the main thing is size. Now, I hope this video is helpful for you today. If you do want to find out more about the Sonnect Sound Bullet, I have a description down below. Also, if there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on any of the products that are out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day. Perfect.